This video introduces the enhancements made to the modeling and editing of railings in ARCHICAD. Several enhancements have been made in modeling and editing of railings. The first of these is that railing components can now participate in solid element operations. Select the railing and click the Edit button to enter edit mode. In this example, we will cut the body of railing posts and inner posts with the body of the top rail and the rail at the bottom. Select the railing posts and inner posts and activate the SEO palette. Then select the top rail and the rail at the bottom and make them the operator elements. Click the Choose Operation button. As you can see, there is no addition and intersection option in the list, as these two operation types do not apply to solid element operations between railing components. Select the Subtraction option and click the Execute button to perform the solid element operation. The body of posts and inner posts is cut by the body of the top rail and the rail at the bottom, producing correct intersection lines between their bodies. The second enhancement is new geometry options for the direction of rail end cuts. Select the end of the top rail and click the Edit button to enter edit mode. Activate the Railing Settings dialog. The Top Rail End Settings panel includes three new buttons in the Sloped Railings field. Using these buttons, you can set the angle of the rail end to, going from left to right, perpendicular, vertical, and horizontal. The third enhancement is graphical editing of top rail ends and rail ends. If you select a rail end in edit mode, you will see one or more hotspots, depending on the geometry method chosen. These geometry methods and their related settings can now be accessed from the info box. When the extension geometry method is chosen, one hotspot is displayed. Using this, you can graphically adjust the length of the first extension of the rail end. When the curve geometry method is chosen, three hotspots are displayed, the first of which works the same as in the previous geometry method. With the second one, you can graphically adjust the radius parameter. When you click the third hotspot, a pet palette appears, using which you can perform one of three editing steps. You can adjust the extension length of the second extension, you can adjust the angle parameter of the curve, or you can define whether the rail end should be curving in the segment plane, in horizontal right, or in horizontal left. You may also use the info box to quickly set certain options, for example, setting the curved rail end to be vertical and extending it to the railing reference line. When the full return geometry method is chosen, four hotspots are displayed, the first two of which work the same as in the previous geometry method. The third hotspot lets you adjust the extension length of the second extension. while the fourth hotspot lets you graphically extend the third extension of the rail end. Railing connections have also received graphical hotspots in edit mode. These work the same as in case of rail ends and depend on the geometry method chosen. When the disconnected geometry method is chosen, hotspots are displayed on both disconnected rail ends. Using these hotspots, you can graphically adjust the extension length of either. Please note that in such a case, the three railing ending cut angle options are available here as well. When the gooseneck geometry method is chosen, four hotspots are displayed. Going from top to bottom, the first hotspot adjusts the horizontal filat radius. The second adjusts the extension length of the gooseneck offset. The third adjusts the gooseneck top filat radius. And the fourth adjusts the gooseneck bottom filat radius. When the direct connection geometry method is chosen, four hotspots are displayed. The top hotspot lets you adjust the extension length of the top connecting rail. While the bottom hotspot lets you adjust the extension length of the bottom connecting rail. By adjusting either of the two middle hotspots, you can set the radius of both connection fillets. Please note that this radius value can even be set to 0 degrees. The geometry method and its related settings may also be set using the info box. With these new enhancements, railings can be more easily created and modified to the exact desired shape and documentation requirements. Please watch all other clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with all stair and railing related enhancements in ARCHICAD 22.